we will see how to test the circularity or roundness of a circular body. The apparatus you see here is the roundness tester. You can test the roundness of either the external surface of a body, or in case if it is a hollow body, you can check the roundness of the internal hole as well. Now we'll see how to operate this machine. First, switch on the machine. Switch on the power supply as well as the machine. And then rotate the platform of the machine just to check whether the level is correct. So you can check if there is any swaying sidewise, or in case if there is any level mistake, you can visually inspect it. In case if there is any swaying or buckling effect, we have four knobs to level it. So the knobs L note the leveling. So there you can see the gap between these two plates. So when you rotate the L knob, it could be increased or decreased. So there you can check. So one side it's high and on the other side it's low, the gap between these two plates. L is for level. And then we have C. This C knob is to center the plate where the object is kept. So once you rotate, it would move to a side. So here you can see there's a gap. So one side it's outside and one side it's inside. And there, once you rotate, you can see the kind of buckle, right? Either in the bottom you can see, or in the top you can see the unsymmetriness. So by rotating the C knob, you can set it for center. In order to measure, we need to bring the probe just touch the surface of the object which is placed over there. So we can do it by adjusting these knobs. So these knobs are provided to adjust this up or down, front or back, or to tilt. So all kind of movements we can do in order to just touch the surface of the body. And then you can start it just to check it as a rough, if there is any buckle or not. Remember that this is just a rough checkup before the actual reading. And then when the probe is just touching the surface, rotate it slightly to make it more accurate to just touch. So here we have two probes. One could be used to measure the outside roundness, and the other one could be used to measure the inside. We can either use both simultaneously, or we can use one after the other. Which probe to select to measure the roundness can be determined by these two buttons A and B. So just touching can be ensured by these lights. So when the lights are coming closer to each other towards the center, it's almost just touching. In case if it is moving either side of left side or right side, either the distance between the probe and the object is high, or the distance between the probe and the object is tight. So by checking the lights, we can ensure whether it is just touching the surface of the body. So these lines can be used as a kind of reference or guidance in order to check whether it's almost placed properly. So there are usual colors, green, orange and red. So if it is in the green range, that's fine. When it's on the orange range, it's almost about to go out of the range, and the red, it's completely out of the range. So we need to check it accordingly. So by rotating it, you can check the lights which are moving either sides. So by that you can check whether it's placed very properly or accurately. And on the top there are certain buttons which is to measure the preciseness, or you can say the accuracy. To make it more clear, when the preciseness is 250 micron, that is first button, the lights were in the first two or three boxes. But when you change the preciseness to 150, that is second button, 150 micron, you see the lights are going beyond the range towards the end, which means, so this preciseness number means the distance between the probe and the object. If you get either orange or red light, then you should adjust by the knobs, either L or C. There are a few terms. What does these terms mean? You can see from the manual. You can select any one of these, whichever you need. And also in the top, there's a graph button, data button, and feed button. So if you press them, you will get the data as a print. So once your setup is over, press the start button. And the machine will start rotating with the object you have already placed. So there you can see it's measuring. And also the light which is moving either sides, which denotes the circularity error on the object. And then once done, stop the machine. And you can take the print. So you can press either data if you want, or you can press the graph if you want, you can press feed if you want the data.